Hi guys, welcome to channel Piping Mantra. For today, we are here with a new exciting interview questions video for piping. Our intent is to help all the piping engineers or designers out there in cracking every interview in these tough times. So, without making this intro any longer, let's get into it. First, what are the different types of valves and their applications? There are different types of valves like gate valve. It is used for on and off control and where there is no need to throttle the flow. It is used in low pressure loss. Ball valve. It is used to allow quick quarter turn off operation and have poor throttling ability. It provides tight shut off. It can handle fluids with suspended solids. Globe valve. It is used for control purposes as it has good throttling ability. It has very less leakage under low pressure when shut off. Butterfly valve. It is generally used for handling large flows of gases or liquids, including slurries. It has low pressure drop. It has advantage on other valve designs in weight, space, and cost for large valve applications. Needle valve. It is used for precise regulation of flow. It is used in flow metering applications and in vacuum systems. It is not used for simple shut-off applications. Diaphragm valve. It is used in systems where it is desirable for operating mechanisms to be completely isolated from fluid. It is suitable for applications where cleanliness, bubble tight shut-off, and chemical compatibility are important. Plug valve. It is used to direct flow between several different ports through one valve. It provides excellent protection for corrosive applications which need tight shutoff. Check valve. It allows fluid to flow through it only in one direction and prevents reverse flow. Next, what are small bore pipes? Pipes with dia less than 2 inches are small bore pipes and are mostly plain end with socket weld end fittings. If you wish to pursue piping course under Piping Mantra, please fill out a Google form attached in the description box below. This will help us in arranging the logistics to start the course. Next, what are critical lengths? Pipes with 12 inch or more diameter size or pipes with critical services or with critical temperature pressure conditions are critical lengths. You can see our video on the same topic for detailed explanation. Next, what type of bends do we use in piping? Other than standard elbows of 1.5D in oil and gas and chemical projects, we normally use 3D to 5D bends, whereas in metal mining project we use 5D to 15D bends in slurry services. You can refer to our another video on fittings for more details on bends. Next, what are the essential data or documents required for preparation of equipment layout? The essential data or documents required are as follows: process flow diagrams, that is PFDs, piping and instrumentation diagrams, that is P&IDs, project design data, equipment sizes and building sizes, overall plot plan, key plan for equipment layout, separation distance or safety distance between equipments, project or client standard. You can refer our video on equipment layouts also. Next, what are the basic principles of locating the equipment irrespective of the type of arrangements? Basic principles to be followed while locating the equipment are as follows: process requirement, economical piping, ease of operation and maintenance, underground facilities. Next, how much distance is kept between columns of a module in piperack? It is normally kept between 6 meters to 8 meters. Next, at which location on rack the wide spacing, that is, spacing more than normal in between the column is necessary? It is necessary at road crossings or where loading or access space is needed. Next, how much headroom clearance is required under the following type of crossing in general? The headroom normally provided is as structural or pipeline inside operating area, requires 7 feet of headroom clearance or 2200 mm. above crest of road for crane movement requires around 23 feet or 7000 mm of headroom clearance. Above crest of road for truck movement needs 20 feet or 6 meters of headroom clearance. Above crest of road between process units requires 15 feet or 4500 mm headroom clearance. Next, what inputs are required for preparing piping layout? The following inputs are required for piping layout: P&ID, equipment layout, piping material specification, equipment data sheets, project or client standards. Next, what inputs are required for preparing plot plan? The following inputs are required for plot plan: PFD, that is process flow diagrams, P&ID, that is piping and instrumentation diagram, process design data, equipment sizes and building sizes, separation distance or safety distance between equipments, project or client standards. So that is it, guys, for today's video. We love reading your comment and suggestions, so please comment below. We do read every single one of your comment. If you like this video, please hit the like button and share with your friends and colleagues who may find it useful. If you have any time, please check out our other videos over there.